Who are you? You look very angry. I would be angry too if I didn't have a body. I am at the Goodwill in Bullhead City, Arizona on my little road trip. So 20% off is what we're gonna get when we go inside and find some goodies to resell. Let's go. Small cart, big cart. We'll go big cart. All right, there's some really good stuff in this little city. I just might have to come here more often because I'm kind of digging it. Like, oh, do you guys know? No, you probably don't. How much I have been wanting one of these glass bird baths. And I just found the hummingbird one for $8.49. Oh yeah, that's coming home with me. All right, we got a whole bunch of bottles over on this side, bottles and jars. And these caught my eye. Roasting water. What is roasting water? Huh. It really is like a thing. Oh, it's a coffee, tea, smooth. Okay. So is this the bottle that something came in? Those are pretty cool. There's two of them. I really kind of like those. They have a really nice look to them. $2.49 each. I'm going to pick them up. Grabbed this really nice decanter off the shelf too. It's, what does it say down there? I can't tell what that says. It's got the cork, not the plastic, makes it an older piece. It's pressed glass with kind of like a daisy pattern. I love it. All right, now we are at the little tchotchke shelves in the back where they put all the little figurines and such. So we're gonna look and see what we can find back here. Looks like some of their holiday stuff is back here mixed in as well. Who are you? You look very angry. I would be angry too if I didn't have a body. All right, there's lots of holiday stuff. More signage. You know what? I just feel like, wait a minute. You stay there. Be right back. Where'd you go? No, I hear you go. You need a friend. There you go. All right, spotted this. Boy, I was really hoping that looked like mushrooms in there, but this is a nice little stained glass dried flower. That's beveled glass. It's actually quite nice. We will pick that up for $3.50. Here, I see the cool little fish planter. He is $3.49. We're gonna pick him up also. All right, what have we got up on this shelf here? Kind of a nice little wood. Actually, it's bamboo. What is bamboo? Unfortunately, you know, almost all the bamboo I see has a crack or two in it. Is that normal? I don't know. This one's signed. You know what? For $3.50, I don't think I can go wrong. All right, I see something else cute. Oh, it's musical. Musical little mirror, vintage mirror. It's plastic though, which is interesting. I don't know how I feel about that. I think I don't feel strongly enough to take it home with me. But the little bird, on the other hand, for $2.49, will be coming home with me. Okay, let's see. That's a candle. Ooh, it's very purple. What can we find? He looks very old. Very old. It's $2.49. He doesn't have a mark, but he is that old sir. Oh, and he's got a girlfriend too. So I think we're gonna pick those up. This guy's just fun. He's just a fun owl. He just have a tag. I don't know who he is. It's $2.49. I think I must have him. May have had a lid at some point, but it's all hand painted. And it's painted on the inside too, and it's only 99 cents, so I'm gonna pick that up. So then I spot this girl. She looks like that Kimple. And she's $3.49, and she's preloaded. There's at least one penny in there already. Oh boy, look at this guy. He is paper mache. Paper mache for $3.49. I do like their pricing here. There is somebody trying out an air compressor. And they're taking a really long time. They're taking a really long time to try out that air compressor. Okay, air compressor testing is done. I can show you this sweet, sweet little teacup and saucer that I found for $1.49. Let's see what we can find. I like their little tchotchke shells. Oh, 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 $2.49. Even though her little petal is chipped, that's a yes. Going for the little pig right here, but when I spotted her, he's also a yes. Look how cute he is. Yes, I see the elephant. Elephant is carved from stone. Ooh. And no issues. Oh, it's $2.49. We'll take him. All right, this is the shelf that just keeps on giving. That is cheap plastic, unfortunately. But look at this. Look at this little bell. How sweet is that? I'm sure that's probably Dell. For $1.49, yeah, we will take you. Get one bell. Now I'm going to take a look at all the bells so that I can put a little lot of bells together. Kind of liking this one with the dolphin on it, which you can't see the dolphin because the tag is kind of over it. So let's move the tag over this way so you can see the dolphin. Actually going to pick up all of these bells. Most of them are $1.49, a couple of them are $2.49. I'm okay with that. These are all really nice little bells. I also picked up this guy here. He's just got vintage written all over him, right? He is Christ and Company, and he was $4.49. And then I got this. This is, see if I can read that mark again. It was Rogers silver plated. So it's a Rogers. Open it up. It's a sweet little jewelry box for $5. Let's see if I missed anything under here. There's a few really good little things in there. Some interesting stuff, but I think I got the best of it. Zodax, made in India. It's kind of cute. And let's look down here. Ooh, footprints plaque. I like that. Got a little, it's resin. It's not actually metal. All right. Okay, he's a wine holder. He's coming home with me. He is $7.49. That is a Beauty and the Beast rose. I don't know if the little lights work anymore, but those little lights are really easy to replace. $4.49? Yes. I found another doggy. This one's a little bit naughty. And it says got beer on his collar. And there you go. Oh, he's $6.49. I sadly did not get to show you the beautiful Black Forest cuckoo clock that was sitting over here, and it was priced at only $8, and the gentleman was agitating over whether to buy it or not, and I was like, leave it, leave it, leave it, leave it. I will snag that up so fast. Birdie coming with me. But no, he took it. I'm like, oh my gosh. That wouldn't have even been a blink of an eye decision. As is this parrot right here that I'm gonna grab. Parrot is stone, and he's $3.49, and he's awesome. Sitting here right in front of me is a little gemstone globe for $1.49. That is also a no-brainer.
This day is just going to the dogs. I found dogs playing poker for $8.49. He is also a wine holder.
Well, the shelves area is a little crowded, so let me show you what I picked up. This pyrography, I think that's how you say it. These are raccoons on a slab of wood for $3.49. I got the buffalo. It's kind of interesting. It is signed by the artist here, $1.49. I got a vintage spoon rest, the acrylic with the beans in there, for $2.49. And a piece of sandstone. And this is the humpback yay. So I'm always trying to decide if something's a cocopelli or a yay or whatever. So that's a yay. Yay!
Love the colors in this Aztec calendar. Kind of enameled brass piece, $3.49. I am gonna pick that up. OMG. That's all I have to say.
I just found this wall pocket. Oh, I just noticed a crack in it though. Darn, that's too bad. $3.49. You know, that crack, it's pretty surface. I might still go ahead and pick that up. I just found this little piece, hand painted. I can't tell. No, that's the painting. Okay, I thought maybe it was a crack. It's not. It's the stems of the flowers. $3.49. You can see the artist signed it right there. Oh my goodness, look at these ladies now. These are also Christ's. See, I'm gonna get her. Yes, someone else is testing the air compressor. She's also Christ's. We're gonna get her. All right, look at the face on this guy. That's a quality face right there. And he's got a dog. I don't know who made this one, but I can tell it's good. And it's only $3.49. Picked up this girl, but she has some broken fingers, which unfortunately is pretty common in these figurines. But I'm gonna sneak back there too and see if I can see what that little France guy is. Oh, and let's pick up the brass elephant for $5. Is a bank, and unfortunately he's quite broken. I don't know who done him. He was super cute, but he's broken. And then I'm gonna look, see what this little egg is right here. Oh, it's not marked. So we're gonna leave the little egg. I think our cart is doing quite well. Found this little talking box here. I'm gonna get it to talk. Hold on. Hold on.
Excuse me, can you let me out of here?
Ma'am, do you have zippers?
Zippers?
Yeah, like sewing zippers.
Yeah.
1997 Sky Kids. That's funny enough. $2.49. I'm gonna get it. About missed this now. Her little beak does have a little bit of damage, but this is a Quarry Critters chicken. I'm not sure I've ever seen a Quarry Critters chicken. So, for $3.49, I have to take her home. This is the state of my cart right now. Oh yeah, and somebody else is trying out the air compressor. I wish they would just buy it. Wow, okay. I think it's time to go check out. A nice man just brought me this bag of all of these little miniature bells for $5. And I will take them. I was heading by kind of the backpacks and luggage area, and some things kind of called out to me, including a Lily Bloom bag. Lily Bloom, really good brand, $6.49. Of course, I have 20% off. The SeaWorld tote. Needs a little cleanup, but I think I can do that. It's a good theme for 4th of July coming up. This was $5. And then I got two leather mini backpacks. I don't know what the brand is on this one, but it's only $5.
And then this one is that buttery soft leather, like buttery, buttery soft leather. This one is Under One Sky. I don't know that brand. It's $14.49 minus the 20%, so it's going to be around, what, 12 bucks. But this is really good quality leather. Fringe, boho. That should be a $30 flip right there. Is this like the cutest thing you ever saw?
It is.
$14.49. It is. I mean, it needs a little cleanup. A little cleanup. What is Betsy Johnson? Look at this one. Look at this. Leather patchworked together. Open it up, and it is beige, made in Italy for $5. I do believe we will take that. Okay, that Goodwill was incredible. Holy moly. I need to come out here more often. I spent $260. And I'm just like thinking to myself, just that glass bird bath bowl is like $50, $60 minimum to purchase. So let's say I spend $200 on all the other stuff. There are several pieces there that are $40, $50. I mean, that was an incredible place to shop. I highly recommend. I mean, there's so much stuff. Bullhead City is not very big, so it looks like they have a lot more donations coming in than they have buyers for the stuff. I mean, the guy that was agitating over spending $8 on a Black Forest cuckoo clock that was in really good condition, I was salivating. I was thinking in my brain, put it back, just put it back, put it back, put it back. But he didn't. He bought it. Really good stuff. I mean, let me just explain that things like the little bells, I'm not buying those to put on eBay. Let me just clarify that. Those are not going on eBay. They will either go into one of my live sales or they will go down to the antique mall booth. Because you need little filler stuff like that. So I want you to understand you need to know your market and where you're selling stuff to know what things to buy for that. Because I get a lot of comments like, well, that's not worth very much. Well, that's junk. Well, I don't buy junk. I guess everyone has an opinion. But I buy it to sell at different places that have a different customer base. And so I know what that is in my head, and I know what my customers will pay for stuff, and that's what you need to learn in your business. That's why I'm all about niche, because if you niche, then you have that customer base and you know what those numbers are. And it just makes it so much easier to go into a Goodwill like that and swoop up all the good stuff and leave the bad stuff on the shelf. Okay, I am gonna hit one more Goodwill on this trip. And of course, that's gonna be in the next video that comes up on the channel. So please subscribe, hit the bell notification, and come back and see what I get at the next one. And most of all, go be profitable and make it fun. And we'll see you on the next one.